जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी यशोदा नंदना ब्रज जन रंजना यमुना तीरा वनचारी यमुना तीरा वनचारी जयो राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी गोपी जना वल्लभा गिरिवरदा गोपी जना वल्लभा गिरिवर दारे यशोदा नंदना व्रज जन रंजना यमुना तीरा वनचारी यमुना तीरावनचार जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी यशोदा नंदना व्रज जन रंजना यमुना तीरा वनचारी हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा जय विष्णुपाद परम सुप्रीव राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर श्रीमद्भाई चरणारविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी प्रभुपाद की जय। जय विष्णुपाद परम सुप्रीव राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर श्रीमद भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय। नमाचार्य शिलोदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्त वृंद श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन की जय। वृंदावन मथुरा धाम की जय। मायापुर नवदीप धाम की जय। गंगा माई की जय। जमुना माई की जय। नर्मदा माई की जय। भक्ति देवी की जय। श्रीमती तुलसी महारानी की जय। समवेत भक्त वृंद की जय। निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण बेष्टाय विद्वते श्रीमते भक्ति विकास स्वामी ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं। वन्देहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं चाग्रजातं सगणरघुनाथान्वितं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सकललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति विकास स्वामी निति नामने नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण भ्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी निति नामने नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे मुखम करति वाचल मंगलम गायति गृहमत कृपात वंदे श्री गुरुदेव तारण ब्रह्मानंद ओम नमो भगवते नमरसिंहाय नमस्तेजस्तेजसे आविर्भव वज्रनख वज्रदंष्ट कर्माशयं रंधय रंधय तमो कृस कृस ओम स्वाहा अभयम अभयमात्मनि भूयिष्ठा ओम श्रौं यदि दास्यसि मे कामान् वरांस्तं वरदर्शव कामानां हृदय संरोहम भवतस्तु वृणे वरम एवं जनम निपतितं प्रपवाहि कूपे कामाभिकाममनुय प्रपदं प्रसंगात् कृत्वात्मसात् शुरर्षिना भगवन् गृहीत सोहं कथं रुपिसृजे तव भृत्य सेवा। हरे कृष्ण डिवोटीज, वेलकम टू येट अनदर सेशन ऑफ द ऑनलाइन रीडिंग ऑफ द बुक ब्रह्मचर्य एंड कृष्ण कॉन्शियसनेस रिटन बाय हिज होलीनेस भक्ति विकास स्वामी महाराज पब्लिश बाय भक्ति विकास ट्रस्ट एंड डेडिकेटेड टू हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी प्रभुपाद। So before starting to read, I would like to request devotees whether they are able to hear me properly or not. If they are able to hear me, then can request somebody to read. Yes. Some devotees complain that it is not clear. Is it clear? Voice is clear. My voice is clear. Clear. Okay, thank you. Oh, staying brahmachari is a very big topic. Okay, I will read that staying brahmachari and then after I'll give to somebody. Staying brahmachari, page number 111. If one can stay a brahmachari without being unduly agitated by sex desire, that is by far the best situation from which to aim at going back to Godhead. Without the heavy burden of family responsibilities, the distractions of social life, and the ever-present opportunity for sense gratification, the brahmachari can live simply and peacefully and dedicate his whole life and energy to understanding Krishna. Without having to cater to the expectations of often materialistic relatives, his only obligation is to please his guru, Hari, and the Vaishnavas. No need to get a job, no need to get a home, no need to go to shopping for saris. Simple, easy, and nice. So even if there is some difficulty or occasional mental agitation, if you can at all do it, stay brahmachari. Avoid family life. Just see the example of Narad Muni and Hayashwas. Srila Prabhupada. Brahmachari life is the easiest ashrama to practice Krishna consciousness from. So little is required, a little prasad, a little service, and 6 feet of space to lie down your head at night and rest so you can continue to serve Guru and Krishna another day. Grihastha may have many responsibilities. A brahmachari has no responsibilities. Only responsibility is to serve Krishna. The real business of human life is to take the responsibility of spiritual advancement. So if one remains brahmachari, he has no disturbance in that responsibility. But if he becomes a grihastha, disturbance is there. You cannot take wholeheartedly the spiritual responsibility. Opting to remain celibate is a great decision. It is called brihadvrata. That is the vow of perpetual celibacy, for it is not at all easy to follow. Mahajana Bhishma was awarded to his name, meaning terrible, by the demigods upon his adopting this vow. For it is indeed a very difficult task to undertake, but for those who adhere firmly to this vow, it practically guarantees liberation. Brahmachari is a path followed by only a few and rarely understood or appreciated. Those who decide to remain lifelong celibates may have to face doubts expressed by those who believe such a determination to be impossible to keep. And considering that several apparently stalwart devotees have fallen into the clutches of women, it may well seem impractical for others to try to maintain such rigid vows. However, the failure or setback of some does not portend failure for all. Although throughout history, some renunciates have fallen victim to women, yet others have resisted female charms and thus gone on to achieve perfection. Our acharyas have never stopped encouraging devotees to aspire for the highest ideal despite the inevitability that some will slip along the way. The most brahmacharis eventually marry certainly does not mean that those determined to remain celibate cannot succeed. Seriously committed brahmacharis try to avoid the unnecessary entanglement of family life by dedicating their lives to Guru and Krishna. Even if householders are doubtful about the chances of such brahmacharis surviving, they need not cynically and unnecessarily try to break the spirit and enthusiasm of brahmacharis by telling them that they are fighting a hopeless battle. Such discouraging words may be due to enviousness on the part of such householders who take perverse pleasure in prodding brahmacharis to totter and fall. Sometimes brahmacharis are accused of hypocrisy, that for all their caution in dealing with women, they are not free from sex desire and should therefore just get married. However, it is understood that the brahmachari is not free from sex desire. If he were, he would not be in the material world, in this material world. Nonetheless, he is following the path by which sex desire is overcome. It is not an easy path and may take many years of careful practice to become perfect. That a brahmachari still has sex desire is not an indictment, nor does it mean that he must get married. That he is committed to fight against Maya is praiseworthy, even if his progress is slow. Of course, those whose minds constantly dwell on sex are not brahmacharis at all and have no business being in that ashram. Srila Prabhupada. My open advice is that if anyone can remain a brahmachari, it is very nice, but there is no need of artificial brahmacharis. In Bhagavad Gita, it is stated that one who exhibits outwardly as self-restrained, but inwardly he thinks of sense gratification, he is condemned as a false pretender. We do not want any false pretenders in numbers, but we want a single sincere soul. The relevant verse is Gita 3.6. One who restrains his senses of action, but whose mind dwells on sense objects, certainly deludes himself and is called a pretender. Those who unnecessarily scorn the glorious Brahmachari ashram like to cite this verse. However, the next verse of Gita 3.7 describes actual brahmacharis. On the other hand, if a sincere person tries to control the active senses of the mind by the mind and begins karma yoga in Krishna consciousness without attachment, he is by far superior. Krishna here speaks of controlling the senses by the mind. Those brahmacharis who try to control the senses by force, by accepting a regimen of severe austerities, almost always fail and collapse miserably into sense gratification. Those who are naturally averse to sex intelligence, for whom living without comforts is pleasurable, who do not have to be coaxed into sadhana and service, are more suited for staying brahmachari. One can remain brahmachari whose desire to satisfy Guru and Krishna is stronger than his desire to satisfy his senses. Such level-headed brahmacharis try to control the active senses by mind, by applying in life what they have heard from Shastra. Those who can come to the platform of realization simply by hearing are most likely to remain brahmacharis for life, whereas those who do not realize what they hear will have to make their own experiences in grihastha ashram. Those intending to remain lifelong brahmacharis should particularly read and discuss those portions of the shastras that emphasize the value of remaining free from sex. The second part of this book provides a comprehensive reader. Shastric descriptions of sexual entanglement are unreversibly factual and strong and are welcomed by renunciates who want to break their material attachments. Those who want to maintain such attachments may dislike such descriptions, but that is simply their misfortune. Those who become entangled, enlivened by such strong statements are fit candidates for trying to remain as brahmacharis. Those who become discouraged, thinking the challenge to overcome sexual attraction to be too tough, are not going to make it. Notwithstanding the opinions of others, the lifelong brahmachari goes on hearing and discussing such descriptions so as to maintain sharp spiritual intelligence. He must be firmly convinced that material life is no better than a ditch into which people pass to. He does not feel brahmacharya to be an oppressively difficult struggle, but counts his blessings daily for remaining safe from family life. The lifelong brahmachari must have a positive, hopeful outlook born of faith in Krishna. Those with a critical, negative mentality cannot remain brahmachari. The lifelong brahmachari also has to develop an inner toughness and self-sufficiency. He maintains his determination even in non-ideal circumstances, such as getting a little personal association with advanced Vaishnavas. His inner resolve is that of a sannyasi, although he has not formally accepted that role. That resolve is to do whatever is necessary to make sure this is his last birth in the material world. A brahmachari who wants to remain as such has to understand that there will always be women in this world, that he cannot run away from the world, and that he must therefore adjust his consciousness to be absorbed in Krishna. Brahme charati iti brahmacharya. Avoidance of women can be practiced to a certain extent, but the real avoidance is not to let the mind indulge in thoughts of sense enjoyment. To one who is actually enjoying brahmasukha, spiritual happiness, the question, should I get married or not, will hardly enter his head. And if it does, he immediately rejects it without dwelling on it and being disturbed by it. Along with the great endeavor to conquer sex desire, devotees who want to stay brahmachari must cultivate a mood of selflessness. Most householders are practically compelled to give more importance to their immediate familial duties than to the mission of Krishna consciousness. The brahmachari's freedom from such obligations is not meant for living a foppish, lazy life, but for cultivating selflessness in the service of Krishna and his devotees. This is a vital key to staying brahmachari. A so-called brahmachari who is selfish and attached should get realistic and get married. Simply a show of brahmacharya is not sufficient, nor can it last. Brahmachari means brahme charati, not nonsense charati. A nonsense person dressed in saffron is not a brahmachari. A real brahmachari is absorbed in service and is surrendered and determined. Brahmachari means strictly following. Brahmacharya life can be counted only by deep absorption in Krishna consciousness. Brahmachari means don't be attached. If you can avoid all this nonsense, that is brahmachari. Try to avoid better. If not, enter family life. Those who are not fully into it are in the wrong ashram. Better they go home and become honest householders rather than making a show of renunciation that they are not fit for. Renunciation is not cheap, but has to be pursued as a lifelong plan. Within this plan, discretion is the better part of valor. Lord Chaitanya cautioned the young Raghunath Das Goswami that the ocean of material existence is very wide and not easily crossed. Just by impetuously jumping into the ocean and making a few mad strokes, we cannot expect to reach Krishna Loka, Satsurup Das Goswami. Some unmarried devotees are clearly unfit for remaining brahmacharis. Those who are not very serious about spiritual life, or who are strongly inclined towards sense gratification, or whose minds are so agitated that they often become upset even over trifles, are obviously in the wrong ashram. They are not to be condemned, for everyone is at a different stage of development, and it cannot be expected that everyone will immediately take to full Krishna consciousness. On the other hand, those who are serious to say brahmachari should definitely be encouraged to do so, and not just married off for the sake of expediency. Our movement needs many examples of devotees who have stuck to Krishna consciousness staunchly without feeling the need for increased sense gratification. Later on, some of the most exemplary lifelong brahmacharis may take sannyas. Sannyas means to be finished with sex life forever, to be saved from family life and to save others from family life. Sannyasis give the greatest service to humanity by traveling everywhere and preaching the message of Krishna unrestrictedly. The sannyas ashram is the ideal for the other three ashrams, which are all meant to lead one to this fourth crest jewel of all ashrams. Traditionally, brahmacharis act as assistants to sannyasis, so to serve and take the association of sannyasis will definitely be a great help for remaining a brahmachari. However, it is not that after several years, a brahmachari necessarily has to opt either for household life or sannyas. The brahmachari ashram is not just for children. Many spiritual institutions in India have senior brahmacharis who are highly respected for their spiritual qualities. Srila Prabhupada wrote that brahmachari and sannyas life are in essence the same, and it was therefore not necessary for every brahmachari to take sannyas. Indeed, in many ways, the brahmachari ashram is the best for spiritual advancement and developing Vaishnava qualities. It facilitates the essential quality of humility, for the brahmachari has neither the positions of a grihastha nor the status of a sannyasi, both of which can foster false pride. Brahmachari life is generally considerably more simple and austere than that of sannyasis in the modern day. Brahmacharis can remain less entangled than sannyasis in the social affairs of householders who prefer to go to sannyasis for blessings and advice, and who like to call sannyasis to their homes and feed them. Brahmachari ashram is also intrinsically the best for nurturing surrender to Guru. Therefore, more important than formally taking sannyas is the firm decision to stay brahmachari with determination, never to engage in sex again. With such a conviction, a brahmachari practices Krishna consciousness with deep faith and commitment. If one wants to stay brahmachari, a whimsical approach will not do. What is required is a firm, steady service, regular potent sadhana, and a deep vision of Krishna consciousness acquired from intensive study of Srila Prabhupada's books. One wants to stay brahmachari, a whimsical approach will not do. What is required is firm, steady service, regular potent sadhana, and a deep vision of Krishna consciousness acquired from intensive study of Srila Prabhupada's books. So with this nice note, I would like to request Rakesh Sharma ji, the new person who has entered. I have given access to you, Rakesh ji. If you have a mic, proper mic, you can continue to read from the page where I stopped. Hare Krishna, are you able to hear me? I don't know whether he is here. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Rakesh Sharma ji. You can find on the top of your screen that you are given access. You have to press yes. Then you can access to the mic. Can get the access to the mic. Hare Krishna, Rakesh Sharma ji. Now he's not able to. Oh, he's come.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
आवाज आ रही है गुरुजी?
हाँ, आवाज आ रही है. आप धन्यवाद प्रणाम. आप अंग्रेजी पढ़ सकते हैं?
आप प्रभु जी पढ़ सकता हूँ.
हाँ प्लीज, आप थोड़ी देर के लिए ये टॉपिक पढ़ सकते हैं तो अच्छा रहेगा.
अच्छा प्रभु जी, एक मिनट. And if you are thinking about getting married, stop it. Much better just to remain brahmachari. If all you have heard about getting married doesn't help you understand, that you shouldn't read on. इट वुड हैव बीन नाइसर नॉट टू हैव सच ए सेक्शन इन दिस बुक बट मैनी ब्रह्मचारीज इवेंचुअली गेट मैरिड एंड सम गाइडेंस इज नीडेड फॉर दैम हैविंग रिसीव्ड द ग्रेट बेनिडिक्शन ऑफ ए ह्यूमन बर्थ एंड द इवन मोर रेयरली अचीव्ड गिफ्ट ऑफ एसोसिएशन विद डिवोटीज वी स्टैंड पॉइज्ड ऑन द थ्रेशोल्ड ऑफ एटर्निटी विल वी बी इंटेलिजेंट एनफ टू परफेक्ट अवर लाइफ lives by fully surrendering to Krishna or will we have to come back again to taste the bitter truth fruits of material life we want Krishna that is why we have taken to Krishna consciousness but to get Krishna the supreme pure we have to become pure hence there is the process of devotional service But it takes time. No one is becoming a pure devotee overnight. We want Krishna, but we are held back by multifarious material desires, especially the powerful sex urge, which haunts us like a repeating nightmare. Therefore, the Vedic social system is arranged for the gradual purification. Of the four ashramas, three are specifically meant for renunciation. And because we Conditioned souls have so many material desires in the grihastha ashrama. Scope is given for limited enjoyment, coupled with the continuous performance of auspicious activities. In youth, the senses are very strong. A conditioned soul may be seriously seeking self-realization, but is not ready for full renunciation. He has the facility to enjoy family life during early manhood. While keeping in contact with Krishna consciousness. When old age approaches, he must again take up a life of penance. Lifelong brahmacharya is for those brahmacharis who never consider marriage as an option. If thoughts of marriage or sex start to linger in the mind of a brahmachari, if he feels dissatisfied with his status as a menial servant or is anxious about his future security, It is an indication that he is probably in the wrong ashrama and should prepare himself for marriage. He should honestly face the question, I may be able to avoid marriage now, but still, will I be able to remain single throughout life? Sometime it is said that family life is the safe path and brahmacharya the easy path. Brahmachari life is by nature simple and in that sense easy, although somewhat austere. It frees its practitioner from unnecessary material entanglements and the problems that go along with them. Thus, a brahmachari remains largely problem-free. A genuine brahmachari has few problems and especially does not have serious mental problems. A brahmachari with many problems should go to the ashrama for working out problems, namely the grihastha ashram, which is by nature full of problems. Indeed, although brahmachari life is considered austere because it tends towards zero sense gratification, the difficulties a grihastha has to undergo to maintain his little sense gratifications are often more than those a brahmachari voluntarily accepts. Thus, the grihastha ashrama is said to be safe but problematic. Whereas the brahmachari ashram is relatively problem-free but can be risky. But in another way, the brahmachari is more safe because he has no opportunity to indulge in sex, whereas a householder may do so at any time. The safety of a householder is that if he is going to indulge in sex, that He may do so illicitly with his wife, whereas a brahmachari,
not illicitly, licitly,
may do so licitly with his wife, whereas a brahmachari who fails to control his senses can only do so illicitly.
Yes.
Brahmachari life is safe, then only if brahmachari is sufficiently controlled to be a real brahmachari. If he is too much agitated by lusty desires, he is unsafe in the brahmachari ashram. And should become safe by entering his householder life. However, it is naive to think that getting married is a cure for sex desire. It is not that easy. Rather, those who are not self-controlled within marriage increase their attachment for sex by indulging in it. Thus, the safety of family life is not without its peril and is hard earned. The best practice of brahmacharya, therefore, is to preserve and remain free from sex. It is not necessary or compulsory that everyone get married. But for one who cannot maintain the firm determination to stay brahmachari and is agitated so severely by material desires that he cannot concentrate properly on service, it may be better for him to get married and be done with it rather than totter on the mental platform indefinitely. An unsteady brahmachari can battle on and try to become more fixed, but unless he soon does so, it may be difficult for him to avoid marriage. From the philosophical standpoint, for a brahmachari to marry doesn't seem to make a lot of sense. The purpose of this movement is to get disentangled from the material world. So to deliberately get re-entangled appears to be self-defeating. Of course, getting married is not an offense and is a reality for most devotees, but a would-be grihastha should know what he is getting into. Marriage is often approached whimsically without enough serious consideration and preparation. It is better to be informed about the responsibility of married life and to have a clear picture of what lies ahead after marriage. Brahmachari should have a mature and proper understanding of what being a grihastha means. Otherwise, they may have a romantic misconception of grihasthashram, which is actually based on the commitment to responsibility, maintain a Krishna conscious family. Brahmachari contemplating marriage should carefully study Prabhupada's extensive instruction on grihastha duties so as not to be bewildered on this point. Brahmachari is in the illusion that family life is nice are advised to lead the forest of material enjoyment. Unfortunately, the power of Maya is such that even upon reading such descriptions of the horrors of the family life, those who are inclined toward it think that such descriptions are exaggerated or would not apply in their case. Be warned, when the scriptures describe the miseries of family life, it is not just theoretical or in reference to mundane marriages only. Licit or illicit, the fleeting delight of sex is always accompanied by suffering. Brahmacharis who doubt this may ask any sober householder what he thinks about family life. Almost all of them will advise to stay brahmachari if possible. Family life is always troublesome, and in today's unsettled and complex world, getting married is a greater risk than ever before. Marriage as an institution has suffered greatly, and devotees' marriage have been no exception. The attempt to make family life smooth and comfortable takes up much of the time and energy of the most householders, yet is nevertheless rarely achieved. The minuscule joy of family life, earned with many difficulties, increase as more children are born. To maintain a wife and family is not easy. In Kali Yuga, a man who can simply maintain a wife and a family is considered to be a highly successful person. If the wife is demanding or not very compatible with the husband, the suffering increases more and more without respite. Therefore, marriage should not be entered into lightly, but with caution, reserve, and soberity. If a man is not prepared to take full responsibility, he shouldn't get married. Whimsically messing up people's life, thinking, well, I will just check it out, and if I don't like it, I will drop it, is one of the symptoms of Kali Yuga mentioned. Mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. The scriptural recommendations about non-attachments are not a wholesale license for irresponsibility. Non-attachment does not mean that a husband should whimsically leave his wife or vice versa. If they are so unattached, then why did they marry in the first place? Many ISKCON devotees have entered into marriage without the sense of commitment demanded by Vedic standards. The resultant divorce rate is even worse than that of the Karlis. Although Srila Prabhupada did not want any divorce at all, this is Kali Yuga marriage. As soon as there is disagreement between husband and wife, as there almost inevitably will be, or if one partner finds the other not sufficiently sexually attractive, then there is separation and divorce. This continues to be a major problem within our society and a cause of losing many devotees to Maya. As long as the divorce syndrome continues in ISKCON, it will be very difficult to substantiate to the world our claim of an alternative, better way of life. Devotees have to become responsible. The father must be responsible to maintain his dependents, both materially and spiritually, without abandoning them whimsically if there is some problem. But the social situation is so unstable that many materially solvent men become pauper overnight. Nor is there any guarantee that one's children are going to be serious about Krishna consciousness. The lure of gross sense gratification has already claimed scores of ISKCON children. The father is responsible for seeing that the wife, children, and other dependents are properly clothed, housed, fed with, and educated, and their health needs are taken care of. Arranging the marriages of the children and especially of the daughters, and more important, ensuring that they get training and guidance in Krishna consciousness. There are quite a few senior grihasthas devotees whose marriage have been more or less successful. So grihasthas to be and newly married couple would be well advised to consult them. In any marriage, the going will not always be smooth. So if you can get some sympathetic help, take it. Now, when to get married and how to go about it? Better not leave it too late. Marriage does not have to be a last grasp rescue attempt for an agitated wreck of a brahmachari. Much better if it can be planned and entered into in a sober manner. The traditional Vedic system is that at about the age of 20, about after 15 years in the Gurukula, a brahmachari sits with his guru to decide whether or not he should be married. Even if the guru directs him towards householder life, the brahmachari may spend a few more years in the Gurukula before getting married without mental agitation caused by uncertainty. Srila Prabhupada recommended that man be married by 25 when in the prime of life and able to easily beget health. Remember, when you get toward 50, you will have to think about renunciation again. So by that time, your first progeny should be grown up. I understand that you do not want to get married now. But if you marry at all, you should marry now, because after the age of 30, marriage is no so pleasing. A brahmachari who has reached his mid-30s would be well advised to remain a lifelong brahmachari, even with difficulties. If by performing humble service and by keeping strong association, he can avoid getting entangled so late in life, then that will be more suitable for spiritual life than becoming a middle-aged bridegroom. Before getting married, however, it is best to get at least 5 good years in the brahmachari ashram. A solid training in renunciation and sense control is a firm foundation for household life. When a brahmachari is confident that he can remain a brahmachari even when living with a woman, then he is ready to enter the grihastha ashram. Remain a brahmachari means that he will continue to be attached to austerity. He will never give up chanting at least 16 rounds, following the four regulative principles, rising early, taking only prasad, etc. His unavoidably increased contact with women, money, sense gratification, and social life will not be the cause of his fall down. Otherwise, we have seen it happen so often. A man prematurely married fails to control his senses and tumbles into a dark well. His Krishna consciousness becomes covered over. He loses the ability to understand what is actually beneficial for him. And his family life become almost exactly like that of a karmi. So, spend some time as a brahmachari. Go through the rigors and ecstasies of book distributions. Study Srila Prabhupada books continue. Conscientiously travel, preach, have some transcendental adventure and fun. Then how to go about getting a suitable partner? This should be done prudently. It is best to take a little time and not to rush into marrying. The Vedic system is that a third party arranges the marriage. Boy and girl would not even see each other till the wedding day. Modernists will protest. But the stability of arranged marriage in India is still far greater than that of love marriages. In the West, brahmacharis whose parents are not Krishna conscious may consult some senior grihasthas for help in arranging a suitable match. Sannyasis and gurus should not be approached as marriage counselors. It is not meant for them. A brahmachari should not hang around the brahmacharis and check them out, thus encouraging looseness. Also, before marriages, both husband must make adequate arrangements for income and accommodation. Srila Prabhupada has given much advice on marriage and how to enter into it in Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 3, Chapter 21 to 24. Brahmachari should not have any stigma against grihasthas or against brahmacharis planning to get married. It is not necessarily true that a brahmachari is any less serious because he is thinking of entering householder life. The brahmacharis who can remain as a brahmachari respect brahmacharis who get married, knowing that their purpose is to come to the transcendental platform. A final point, make up your mind. Do not flip-flop, changing back and forth from saffron to white clothes like a chameleon. Srila Prabhupada wrote many letters to devotees who were considering whether or not to get married, and some quotations have been reproduced in the appendix so that
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Oh, nicely reading. Suddenly, what happened? Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Krishna consciousness. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
You have to read from first, Prabhu. Srila Prabhupada wrote many letters like that. Because it got cut. वो कट हो गया बीच में.
अच्छा अच्छा पीछे वाला पेज कट हो गया.
हाँ नहीं नहीं आप शिला प्रभुपाद रोट मेनी लेटर्स ऐसा करके बोल रहे थे ना वहाँ से पढ़िए एक बार.
That was on previous page ना प्रभुजी.
या previous page.
I cannot see that now. अच्छा.
वो लास्ट में एंड पे होता है शिला प्रभुपाद रोट मेनी लेटर्स टू डिवोटीज.
So
ये फाइनल पॉइंट उसके बाद
ठीक है सॉरी ये लास्ट में मैं सोच रहा था पेज बदल गया. हां शीला प्रभुपाद रोट मेनी लेटर्स टू डिवोटीज हु वर कंसीडरिंग वेदर और नॉट टू गेट मैरिड एंड सम कोटेशन हैव बीन रिप्रोड्यूस्ड इन द अपेंडिक्स सो दैट डिवोटीज प्रेजेंटली इन द सेम प्रेडिकमेंट कैन टेक एडवांटेज ऑफ हिज एडवाइस.
ओके प्रभु जी अभी मैं दूसरे डिवोटीज को बोलता हूं पढ़ने के लिए वो भी है. थैंक यू बहुत-बहुत धन्यवाद. बहुत अच्छा पढ़ा आपने. बहुत फीलिंग फीलिंग के साथ पढ़ा है. थैंक यू ब्रो जी. हरे कृष्ण
हरे कृष्ण.
क्षितिज शर्मा, क्षितिज क्षितिज आर यू प्रभु जी? आई थिंक सो, और कैन आई रीड? वेरी नाइसली रेड प्रभु जी. क्षितिज क्षितिज
प्रभु जी, एम आई ऑडिबल?
या, यू आर ऑडिबल. यू आर कमिंग टुडे इटसेल्फ. आई थिंक टुडे द फर्स्ट यू आर
यस
अटेंड. ओके.
यस एक्चुअली आई हैव टेकन द बुक एंड लकीली टुडे आई जॉइंड, सो आई एम आल्सो एट द सेम टॉपिक.
ओके. सो वी आर इन पेज नंबर समथिंग लाइक
यस द
ब्रह्मचारी
ऑथर.
रीडर.
या
या, सो यू कैन रीड दिस वन एंड देन यू कैन कंटिन्यू टू रीड अंटिल आई से टू यू टू स्टॉप. यू कैन रीड, नो प्रॉब्लम.
ओके.
सो सॉरी, आई एम गिविंग यू द पेज विच इज नॉट द मेन कंटेंट, बट स्टिल यू कैन रीड इट. आफ्टर दैट यू कैन कम टू द कंटेंट. ओके. हाँ,
ओके. सो
या,
प्रभु जी,
आई
आई एम
विल.
रीडिंग
या, यू कैन रीड, कंटिन्यू.
ऑथर. सो बोर्न इन ब्रिटेन इन 1957, द ऑथर जॉइंड इस्कॉन इन लंदन इन 1975 एंड वाज इनिशिएटेड दैट ईयर विद द नेम इलापति दास बाय द फाउंडर आचार्य हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी प्रभुपाद. फ्रॉम 1977 टू 1979 इलापति दास वाज बेस्ड इन इंडिया एंड मोस्टली ट्रैवलिंग इन वेस्ट बंगाल डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग शिला प्रभुपाद्स बुक्स. ही स्पेंड द फॉलोइंग 10 ईयर्स हेल्पिंग टू पायनियर इस्कॉन्स प्रीचिंग इन बांग्लादेश, बर्मा, थाईलैंड एंड मलेशिया. इन 1989 ही वॉज ग्रांटेड द ऑर्डर ऑफ संन्यास रिसीविंग द नेम भक्ति विकास स्वामी एंड अगेन मेड हिज बेस इन इंडिया. सिंस ही हैज प्रीच्ड कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस थ्रू आउट द सब कॉन्टिनेंट, लेक्चरिंग इन इंग्लिश, हिंदी एंड बंगाली एंड ऑल्सो स्पेंडिंग अ फ्यू मंथ्स ईच ईयर प्रीचिंग इन द वेस्टर्न हेमिस्फेयर. हिज टेलीविजन लेक्चर्स इन हिंदी हैव बीन व्यूड बाय मिलियंस वर्ल्ड वाइड. भक्ति विकास स्वामी राइट एक्सटेंसिवली ऑन कृष्णा कॉन्शियस टॉपिक्स. हिज बुक्स हैव बीन ट्रांसलेटेड इन टू ओवर 20 लैंग्वेजेस विद मोर देन 400,000 इन प्रिंट. ब्रह्मचारी रीडर्स, सो शिला प्रपाद एंड अदर्स ऑन ब्रह्मचर्य, मैरिज, द डेंजर्स ऑफ सेक्सुअल अट्रैक्शन एंड रिलेटेड टॉपिक्स एस्पेशली रेलेवेंट फॉर ब्रह्मचारीज. फॉलोइंग इज अ सीरीज ऑफ कोट्स एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम शिला प्रपाद्स बुक्स, लेटर्स, रिकॉर्डेड लेक्चर्स एंड कन्वर्सेशंस एंड फ्रॉम रिलायबल एनेक्डोट्स विच कॉम्प्लीमेंट द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ दिस बुक. देर आर मैनी इंपॉर्टेंट श्लोकाज रिलेटिंग टू द कंट्रोल ऑफ सेंसेज एंड द माइंड इन भगवद गीता एंड सेवरल लॉन्ग सेक्शंस इन भागवतम विच आर इन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ब्रह्मचारीज. टू सेव स्पेस वी हैव नॉट बीन प्रिंटेड दीज हैव नॉट बीन प्रिंटेड इन दिस बुक. रेफरेंसेज टू देम आर गिवन बिलो. गीता वर्सेज रेफरेंसेज आर देयर. देन इंपॉर्टेंट पैसेजेस फ्रॉम श्रीमद भागवतम आर देयर. देन श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत अंत्य लीला चैप्टर 3, द पनिशमेंट ऑफ जूनियर हरिदास इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंस्ट्रक्टिव. रिकमेंडेड फर्दर रीडिंग रिगार्डिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ सेलिबेसी, ब्रेन गेन बाय हिज होलीनेस दानवीर गोस्वामी, राज 2005, रूपानुग वैदिक कॉलेज, कैंसास सिटी, यूएसए. ओके. कोर्स फ्रॉम श्रीमद भागवतम. The whole material creation is moving under the principle of sex life. In modern civilization, sex life is the focal point for all activities. One cannot enter into the kingdom of God unless one is perfectly cleared of all sins. The material sins are products of our desires to lord it over material nature. It is very difficult to get rid of such desires. Women and wealth are very difficult problems for the devotee making progress on the path back to Godhead. Many stalwarts in the devotional line fell victim to these allurements and thus retreated from the path of liberation. But when one is helped by the Lord himself, the whole process becomes as easy as anything by the divine grace of Lord. To become restless in the contact of women and wealth is not an astonishment. because every living being is associated with such things from remote time, practically immemorial, and it takes time to recover from this foreign nature. But if one is engaged in hearing the glories of Lord, gradually he realizes his real position. By the grace of God, such a devotee gets sufficient strength to defend himself from the state of disturbances, and gradually all disturbing elements are eliminated from his mind.
You can read the reference also, Prabhu. First canto, second chapter, 17th verse.
Yeah, first canto, second chapter, 17th verse.
Yeah.
In the system of Varnashram Dharma, which is the beginning of actual human life, small boys after 5 years of age are sent to become brahmacharis at Guru's ashram, where these things are systematically taught to boys, be they king's son or sons of ordinary citizens. The training was compulsory, and not only to create good citizens of the state, but also to prepare the boy's future life for spiritual realization. The irresponsible life of sense enjoyment was unknown to children of the followers of Varnashram system. Without being self-controlled, without being disciplined, and without being fully obedient, no one can become successful in following the instructions of spiritual master, and without doing so, no one is able to go back to Godhead. So Bhagavatam, chapter 1.
Canto 1.
Canto, chapter
5.
24th verse.
Yes.
The main purpose of Varnashram Dharma is to awaken knowledge and detachment. The Brahmachari Ashram is the training ground for prospective candidates. In this ashram, it is instructed that this material world is not actually the home of living beings. The conditioned souls under the material bondages are prisoners of matter, and therefore self-realization is the ultimate aim of life. The whole system of Varnashram Dharma is a means to detachment. One who fails to assimilate this spirit of detachment is allowed to enter into the family life with same spirit of detachment. Therefore, one who attains the detachment may once adopt the fourth order, namely renounced, and thus live on charity only, not to accumulate wealth, but just to keep body and soul together for ultimate realization. Household life is for one who is attached, and the vanprasth and the sannyas orders of life are for those who are detached from material life. The Brahmachari ashram is especially meant for training both the attached and detached. Canto 1, 9th chapter, 26th verse. It is essential that one practice self-control by celibacy without the least desire for sex indulgence. For a man desiring to improve the conditions of his existence, self-sex indulgence is considered suicidal or even worse. Therefore, to live apart from family life means to become self-controlled in regard to all sense desires, especially sex desires. Canto 2, 1st chapter, 16th verse. The grossest type of anartha which binds the conditioned soul in material existence is sex desire. And this sex desire gradually develops in union of male and female. When the male and female are united, the sex desire is further aggravated by accumulation of buildings, children, friends, relatives, and wealth. When all these are acquired, the conditioned soul becomes overwhelmed by such entanglements, and the false sense of egoism or the sense of myself and mine becomes prominent. And the sex desire expands to various political, social, altruistic, philanthropic, and many other unwanted engagements, resembling the form of the sea waves, which becomes very prominent at one time and at the next moment vanishes as quickly as a cloud in the sky. The conditioned soul is encircled by such products as well as the products of sex desire, which is summarized in the three headings, namely profit, adoration, and distinction. All conditioned souls are met after these different forms of sex desire. One shall see for himself how much he has been freed from such material hankerings based primarily on sex desire. As a person feels his hunger satisfied after eating each morsel of foodstuff, he must similarly be able to see the degree to which he has been freed from sex desire. The sex desire is diminished along with its various forms by the process of bhakti yoga, because bhakti yoga automatically, by the grace of the Lord, effectively results in knowledge and renunciation, even if the devotee is not materially well educated. Knowledge means knowing things as they are, and if by deliberation it is found that there are things which are at all unnecessary, naturally the person who has acquired knowledge leaves aside such unwanted things. When the conditioned soul finds by the culture of knowledge that material necessities are unwanted things, he becomes detached from such unwanted things. This stage of knowledge is called vairagya, or detachment from unwanted things. We have previously discussed that the transcendentalist is required to be self-sufficient and should not beg from the rich blind persons to fulfill the bare necessities of life. Sukhdev Goswami has suggested some alternatives for the bare necessities of life, namely the problem of eating, sleeping, and shelter, but he has not suggested any alternative for sex satisfaction.
Great.
One, the sex desire still with him, should not at all try to accept the renounce order of life. For one who has not attained to this stage, there is no question of renounced order of life. So by the gradual process of devotional service under the guidance of a proper spiritual master and following the principles of Bhagavatam, one must be able to at least control the gross sex desire before one accepts the renounced order of life factually. So purification means getting freed gradually from sex desire. Second canto, second chapter, 12th verse. From the Lord's genitals originate water, semen, generatives, rains, and the procreators. His genitals are the cause of a pleasure that counteracts the distress of begetting.
Okay, Prabhuji, I will request some of the devotee to read for a few times. Thank you, Prabhu. Aapne acha padha.
Prabhuji, what is the meaning of this last line? His genitals are the cause of a pleasure that counteracts the distress of begetting.
Because the Lord is the supreme pleasure, so his genitals are the cause which contracts, because in this material world there is a distress which comes because of the genitals of using in for begetting, because that is the one which they use for begetting. But for the Lord it is not distress, for the Lord it is pleasure. Whatever is distress for us is actually pleasure for the Lord. Whatever is in this world considered very abominable for the Lord, it is considered, it becomes very pleasurable. In this material world, the relationship between boy and girl is considered the most abominable. But the same thing between Krishna and Radharani is considered the topmost pleasure. So it's like that.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Thank you. Hare Krishna. Yeah, I will like to stop here, and if devotees have some questions, they can ask. Already the devotee has asked. If somebody devotees wants to ask some more questions, then they can ask. If just 2 minutes are left, they can type the question, or if they want to speak out the question, I can give access to the mic. Otherwise, you can just type on the chat box or in the question box. Today, many devotees are inspired to read and hear very nicely. They are becoming focused. Everybody is hearing. Yeah, if you have any questions, then please, Prabhujis or Matajis. Otherwise, we can stop here. Okay, then we can stop here. Sorry, I could not give to all devotees for reading because the topics were so big and it was going on very seriously. So I couldn't switch between devotees, because otherwise time just goes in switching between devotees. So I thought only one devotee can read the whole topic. Yes. Okay, thank you very much. Hare Krishna. We will meet tomorrow. Continuing to read from page number 130. So all the those devotees who have come today, please do come tomorrow also to attend. We want your association. We want your reading. So everybody, tomorrow I will try to give a chance to read, maybe everybody to read, maybe one, two pages. Everybody can read. These are all Prabhupada's beautiful purports, which will help us to become more focused in Krishna consciousness. Who reads is not so important, Prabhuji. Reading is going on smoothly. Yeah, that is important. Yeah, it's a humble approach from your side. Thank you very much. Thanks for your understanding. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Vancha kalpatarubhyascha kripa sandebhyevacha apaditanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha. Dante nidhaya tranakam pratayor nipatya kritvacha kakushatam etad aham bravimihe sadhava saklamev vihaya dhura chaitanya chandra charane कुरुतानुरागात हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे थैंक यू वेरी मच सो वी एक्सपेक्ट दैट ऑल डिवोटीज कम ऑन टाइम टुमारो सो दैट वी कैन स्टार्ट अर्ली हरे कृष्ण थैंक यू वेरी मच